Stephanie with Real Estate Real Talk, and I am so excited to share with you about an amazing topic that we're going to talk about. Just some questions that people ask me: when is the best time to purchase a home? If you just tuned in, my name is Stephanie Velez, and I have a show that's every Wednesday from 12:15 Pacific Standard Time. It's called Real Estate Real Talk, and on this show, we discuss information about you being a home buyer or even a home seller, and pertinent information that will help you in the process, as well as hopefully answer some questions that maybe you've been thinking about. So, little change of scenery. I thought that since this is a home show, that I would do the broadcast today from my balcony, a place that I don't necessarily come to too often, which I probably should, because it's just absolutely gorgeous out here. And so I thought that today I would cover something that I really think will be very beneficial to you if you are considering purchasing a home right now. And the question that I'd like to answer, or at least try to answer today, is when is the best time to buy? Oh my gosh, that is a fully loaded question. I can't tell you how many times I meet people and they're just kind of hanging on the fence, waiting for the market to tank or waiting for the best time to buy. And so really the best time to buy is when you're ready. Okay, I know. The best time to buy is when your situation is the best situation for you. And I normally tell people, don't think about buying a home as far as the costs associated with it, because what happens is the later that you wait, there may be an opportunity. What happens is you may say, I don't think I want to buy this year because I want to wait to see what happens to the market. And so next year you decide that you want to buy, and because you waited to see what was going to happen, you might have priced yourself out the market and you're not able to qualify because the houses are more expensive. So the best time, I believe, for you to purchase is when you're ready. So when is the best time to buy? Well, I think before I can really answer that question, I think I need to go through you what we would consider real estate seasons. And just like we have four seasons, winter, spring, summer, and fall, guess what? There are seasons in real estate that I have seen and that statistics have shown that are the best time seasonally for buyers to possibly purchase a home. So let's talk about winter. So winter is typically, we call it the holiday Thanksgiving time. And this is the time of year when people are they've had Thanksgiving, their family is coming over, and so we consider this the winter time. Spring, we would and that would be from mid November to February. So we consider winter season in real estate to be from Thanksgiving time or middle of November to February. And then there is a springtime season in real estate, which we would consider that time. People look at purchasing homes will be from March to May. And we are right now at the end of the spring season if we were talking about real estate. And then there's the summer season for purchasing, which is typically from June to mid-August, normally when kids go back to school. And then we have the fall season of purchasing homes regarding real estate. That's from September to around mid-November. So you can kind of see that some of the seasons correlate to our real seasons, but I'm going to tell you the actions that are involved in those seasons in as it pertains to real estate are very different. Okay, so let's talk about winter. So when I've worked with buyers during the winter months, remember that's right after Thanksgiving, right all the way to, I would say, February through February, we would call that winter period the holiday season. And this is when people are kind of like, sellers are thinking, hey, the family's coming in, the kids are coming from back from college. I don't really want to show my house as much, you know, I'm just getting ready for that. And so the thing that I would tell buyers is if you are thinking about purchasing home during the winter season, actually it's a great opportunity for you because number one, there's less people looking. Even buyers themselves themselves are trying to get ready for the holidays. They're trying to get their family together. They're buying presents. They're spending their closing costs. They're getting ready to just celebrate with their family. And so what happens is during that time, the winter time of buying homes in real estate, a lot of buyers just kind of sit on the sidelines and enjoy the holidays and then wait till the beginning of the year. Same thing with sellers. So for you, if you're thinking about buying a home, maybe the winter time is a good time for you. Now, here's the downside of that. The downside is a lot of times it's a little bit more difficult to preview homes because sellers know, hey, I don't want to have to show my home. My family's coming over and I don't want to have to clean up. I have too many people over. So the inventory gets a little tighter during the winter months. Because what happens again, people don't necessarily want to show their home. So for you as a buyer, great opportunity, not a lot of competition for you in the market. The downside is a little less inventory that's available for you. Okay, so let's go on and let's talk about spring. So when we talk about the springtime for buyers to purchase homes, we're looking at the time period of March through May. Okay, so March, April, May is typically the time when buyers, when we call it the real estate springtime. And there's a lot of wonderful things that happen during the springtime season of real estate. What we see is that a lot of homeowners are saying, okay, I think I want to sell. And they're deciding to put their house on the market. So that's a good thing because that means that the inventory is going to be a little bit more for you as a buyer to look at and to decide what type of homes you want or what's your fit or what's not your fit. That's the pro side. The other thing is that even in the springtime, what we've seen is that even buyers are kind of sitting back a little bit to see, okay, are the sellers going to reduce prices? They're kind of deciding if they want to buy. And so for you as someone who's ready to purchase a home, this might also be a great opportunity for you to think about buying a home right now because in the springtime, because there might be still a little less people who are in the market like yourselves as buyers looking for homes. Okay, so talking about summer. So we typically see the summer start to happen between June, July, mid-August. And this is what we would call the summer season of real estate. And really, it's a great season for both sellers and buyers. And here's what I mean. So in the summer months, the pro for a buyer is that there is a lot of more homes on the market. And that means that you may have a much better selection to choose different homes that you are interested in. Now, here's the downside of that. Everybody's waiting for that market. And so what happens is that you have sellers thinking, since I know it's a lot of buyers that want to move during the summer months, then I could probably ask a little bit more for my house because I know that they need to move before their kids start school. So you might see in the summer months, which would be June, July, August, prices are a little bit higher. But remember I started out saying the best time to buy is when it's the best time to buy for you. So prices are slightly higher. Sellers, again, are thinking, I can get a little bit more money. Okay. And what we see then is we also see from a buyer perspective or from an agent perspective, a lot of times it's a little bit more difficult to get transactions accepted because sellers are kind of holding out to see if they can get the most money. All right. And then finally, we come to the season called fall, the fall real estate market, which is technically after the kids have started school. Maybe that's late August, September, October, headed into the middle of November. And we would say that's kind of like the fall. So I say this, the fall months are amazing time for you to purchase as well, because if you don't have children and you're not really worried about school or when it starts, you're at a great advantage because really you can move into a home at any time. And fall, what we've seen is there's usually a reduction from the summer inventory because people have purchased homes and then sellers are thinking, well, you know, if we sell our home and we need to move, I don't really want to move during the holiday season, which is winter. So we'll see a lot of homes start to fall off the market and sellers will start to hold back. The one thing I want to say is, you know, as a buyer, be open. I normally tell buyers, sometimes it's not necessarily the specific community that you want. You know, a lot of times you may find the same type of house for the price that you're willing to pay, maybe 5-10 miles away, and it's not that big of a difference for you, but you'll still be able to get the home that you're looking for. Might be in the district where your kids want to be. You'll be happy. The house looks like looks the way you want it to look. And so don't be afraid to kind of open up your parameters, because you never know, you may find that diamond that you've been looking for. Again, my name is Stephanie Velez. This is Real Estate Real Talk. You can tune in every Wednesday from 12:15 Pacific Standard Time to hear interesting tips, facts, and things that can help you come to the decision of purchasing a home. Until next week, we'll see you then. Have an amazing, amazing week. God bless you.